Hello,
we are the Jeffersons, and this is our story.
I grew up in the church when I was young, and I was baptized at a young age. But I stepped away from church for a little while, and I started listening to Bible-speaking preachers, and that's what got me back into the church.
I was born and raised in the church back in Buffalo, New York, and our parents took us to church all the time. At least my mom did. My father went special occasions. And as I got older, I knew there was always something that was just pulling at my heart.
I found out I had a tumor on my chest, and I had no idea. After the first surgery, I ended up having a pulmonary embolism in October of 2019. At the time, the doctor told me, had I gotten to the hospital an hour later, it would have been too late. God just orchestrated things in a way that it just blessed me, and I'll never forget that.
My twin sister was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. And even through the midst of that, I kept saying, Lord, why? What's going on? What did I do? But the Lord said, trust me. That's all I can bring. Trust me. Be still. Trust me. And even when I lost my sister a year ago, I said, Lord, I said, to you I live, for you I die. I still give God the praise because the fact is, he did heal her. But he didn't heal her the way I wanted, but she's healed. She's in no more pain.
One of my greatest experiences has been in creative arts. When we've had the ability to do a play and people give their life to Christ because of it, it makes me feel like I have contributed to people who God wants to return to his kingdom. And that is the greatest, greatest feeling.
I became an usher, been in the choir. I even dibbled and dabbled in creative arts too. Scared the bejeebus out of me, but I did that too. You cultivate such wonderful friends, and those friends are not just friends, they're family now. Curtis and I met here at the church, and we went through new members through the church, and we went through the premarital and all that good stuff. But the thing about it, it's not about coming here to get a husband. It's about coming here to grab hold of the Word of God. And I've learned in all these years I've been in Nations Force since 1998 that there's more work for me to do. And you'll see a smile on my face. Even if I'm going through something, I'm going to smile because guess what? God says, I have a reason for what you're going through.
When you come to church, the greatest thing that you should be seeking is a relationship with God. And that's beyond anything, the best thing that you can have in life. Once you have a relationship with him, you can overcome any situation.